Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining me today for this online tech talk. My name is Rachel Fu, and I'm a senior technical product manager with the AWS Database Migration Service. Today, I'm going to talk about AWS DMS Fleet Advisor, which can help to accelerate database and analytics migration planning. So in this presentation, we will first cover a brief overview of AWS Database Migration Service, then an overview of DMS Fleet Advisor. So finally, we'll run through a demo of how Fleet Advisor actually works. So one quick note before we begin, at any time during this session, if you have questions, feel free to post them in your respective viewing channel. We do have experts who are monitoring to answer any of your questions. So AWS provides help across the migration journey through people, programs, and tools. And DMS really covers the tooling in this space. So in the assessment phase of migration, DMS provides Fleet Advisor, which is really geared towards customers looking to move a fleet of databases to the cloud. So this tool inventories and analyzes your data to quickly create a migration plan. In the mobilize phase, DMS provides schema conversion, which assesses schema compatibility of source databases, and then attempts to convert all schema and code objects. In the migrate and modernize phase, DMS migrates the data with pre-migration assessments and data validation, and this all helps to ensure that the migration is completed properly. So in today's session, we're really going to focus on DMS Fleet Advisor in the assessment phase. So Fleet Advisor is a discovery tool that is free to use, and it can help save on costs associated with migration planning. Fleet Advisor currently supports Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, and Postgres. So how can Fleet Advisor really help with migration planning? Well, the base requirement for migration planning is having an inventory of on-premises databases. And here Fleet Advisor provides an agentless data collector that can automatically discover OS and database servers. You can begin discovery from a lightweight directory access protocol or LDAP server, or alternately you can import a CSV file of OS or database servers. Next, for each on-prem database in the inventory, you need to know if there are any showstoppers or actions that you would need to perform in order to migrate that database to AWS. So Fleet Advisor highlights these limitations or action items, and these could be things like database features that are used by your on-prem database that aren't supported by RDS or Aurora, or maybe hardware limitations like storage limits that you might need to consider. Fleet Advisor also gathers utilization metrics, and then based on this data, it identifies the right-sized RDS or Aurora database instance to migrate to. And then finally, Fleet Advisor shows you all of your valid migration options with the associated estimated costs, and this makes it really easy to evaluate different trade-offs. So how does it work? So I mentioned earlier that Fleet Advisor has a local data collector that's installed in your network to gather data from on-prem databases. This collected data is then uploaded to your Amazon S3 bucket and then populated into the DMS console from there. So from the DMS console, you can analyze the schemas, you can compute recommendations, and then you can view performance or utilization metrics in CloudWatch, or you could move to the AWS pricing calculator if you wanted to further explore cost optimizations. After exploring and fine-tuning the recommendation, you can then switch to the RDS console to create the RDS instance based on the recommendations provided. So the metrics that are gathered by Fleet Advisor can be categorized into either database metadata or information for migration assessment. So database metadata is pretty straightforward, and this includes things like schema structure, database version, accounts for schemas, tables, triggers, views, stored procedures. While migration assessment data is really more used to determine, okay, which databases should be migrated. And this is looking at factors such as support dates, complexity, or similarity of schemas to help identify duplicates. And then complexity is looking at code size and line count. So schema similarity is really based on kind of the number of common object names that the different schemas have. So for security or confidentiality reasons, we also note that Fleet Advisor is not collecting row details or any data from the user tables. So to generate migration recommendations, effectively our algorithm is taking as input CPU, memory, IOPS, IO throughput, and total database size, and this is from an EC2 or an on-prem database, and then providing as output recommended instance specifications for the Aurora or RDS instance that you should migrate to. And these specifications include things like instance type, storage amount, provisioning IOPS, and the associated estimated monthly cost. To run the local data collector, you first install it by running the .msi installer. You configure credentials to forward the data to AWS, and then you can discover OS and database servers, optionally configuring an LDAP connection. So once you've identified the database servers that you're interested in, you select them to be monitored, and then you initiate data collection of either metadata and database capacity, or metadata, database capacity, and utilization metrics for a specific time period. And we'll see this in the demo. If you use the AWS Application Discovery Service, or ADS, you can also do the same database discovery and data collection for Fleet Advisor. ADS offers two ways of performing discovery and collecting data. You can do agent-based discovery by deploying a discovery agent on each of your VMs and physical servers. Agentless discovery is done using the agentless collector through your VMware vCenter. The agentless collector has multiple collection modules, which reduces the time to migration since you don't need to deploy multiple service-specific collectors. So the VMware vCenter data collection module collects server inventory, profile, and utilization data from your VMware VMs, and this server data is forwarded to the AWS Migration Hub. The database and analytics collection module can do database discovery and metrics collection and forwards this information to the DMS console. Okay, so here we're in the DMS console and we're going to create a data collector as our first step. So the first thing is we'll give the data collector a name, an optional description, and then we need to specify the S3 bucket where the data from the collector is going to get uploaded. So this S3 bucket was created beforehand, and then we also need to give DMS an IAM role that gives access to that S3 bucket. So we'll now create this data collector, and we will see it show up in our list of data collectors in waiting to be registered status. So the next thing we're going to do is actually go in and download the local collector .msi installer. So again, it just downloads as a local installer, and then we'll go and switch over to our local environment. So we click on the MSI installer. It goes through the pretty quick installation wizard here. We can just keep clicking through next, and then it's going to install our local collector. All right, so the first time you launch this, it's going to ask you for a username and password, and this is going to be the username and password that you will use subsequent times when you launch the collector. All right, so now we're in the local collector. The first thing we're going to do is configure data forwarding by adding our IAM access key ID and secret access key. And then this allows us to connect to that data collector in the console that we had created that was waiting to be registered. So we save that information, we can see that now we are connected to our Amazon S3 bucket, and we also have access to DMS. So for this demo, we're going to start discovery from an LDAP server. So we're going to add our LDAP server with our username and our password. So we'll add that, and it looks like our connection status is passed. So next, we'll move to discovering OS and database servers. So we'll move to the discovery side navigation here, and we're going to run OS server discovery based on that LDAP server that we had provided. So it's discovered 6 OS servers, which we're going to add to monitored objects. So next, we're going to do database server discovery. And again, it's going to be on that LDAP server and then those OS servers that were discovered. So it's going to go in and it's going to discover these 3 database servers. All right, so we're going to add these databases to our monitored objects as well. So that means we're interested in doing data collection on these database servers. Okay, so now we have our database servers and our monitored objects. And what we can do is, so for MySQL and PostgreSQL databases, we are actually gathering the resource utilization metrics from the host OS server. So we need to make sure that host OS server is linked and that we have the right credentials to connect to that OS server to gather our utilization metrics. Okay, so if we go back to the console, we can see that our collector is now active. If we go to the inventory tab or the inventory side nav, we can see, okay, the databases that we've discovered are now there. Okay, next we're going to go back to our local collector. We're going to select these databases and we're going to run data collection. So you have two options. You can do metadata and database capacity, or you can do those with resource utilization. So to start with, because it's a much faster operation, we're just going to do metadata and capacity. And so again, this is not going to be doing any utilization monitoring. This is just getting, okay, what is the capacity of the current database servers that you have? So this is a good place to start because this allows you to do your recommendations kind of based on existing capacity, and it's kind of a smaller time investment here. So we can do it. See, it's done a bunch of summaries. So we can go in and investigate any failed queries. And now we're kind of back in the console and we're seeing, okay, we have that collected information. Okay, so now we're going to go back into here, and then we're also going to initiate a data collection with the resource utilization turned on. So in here, you have to specify, okay, what kind of time range do you want for those performance metrics? Usually that kind of depends on what your workload looks like, you know, if 2 days or a week is enough to gather sufficient performance metrics to cover the use case. So one of the other things we can do in Fleet Advisor is an inventory analysis. And what this does is it goes in and analyzes all of the schemas that are part of these databases that you've discovered. And what this can tell you is it gives you information on schema complexity, and it can identify schema similarities to tell you, okay, you know, which schemas are duplicates of others, which may be in, you know, different environments, so that you know which schema you is the base schema that you want to migrate. Okay, so the next thing we'll do is generate target recommendations. So we'll go into the side navigation for recommendations, and we see we have a nice How It Works panel to explain, you know, the steps we need to go through, and we'll go ahead and generate recommendations. So the first thing is selecting which databases you want to generate the recommendations for, and then you have some settings for, you know, is this a multi-AZ or a single AZ recommendation that you would like for a production or a dev or test environment. And then you have the choice of using, you know, either the total capacity metrics or the resource utilization, depending on what type of metrics that you've gathered. So if you do choose total capacity, if your source database was over or under provisioned, then your recommendation will similarly be over or under provisioned. And you'll be able to see that when we look at the source utilization metrics. Okay, so now we're generating the recommendations, so we can see the status of the recommendations for our different source databases are currently in progress. And then we have created the recommendations for each of these source databases. So we can see the recommended target engine. We can see the estimated monthly costs that go with that instance class that was recommended. So we can also dig into the individual recommendations here. And we can see, okay, so for this particular source database, we have an Aurora and we have an RDS for MySQL recommendation. We can see the different estimated costs and the different instance classes. So you can dig further into, you know, this particular recommendation for Aurora, and you can see vCPU, you can see storage type, and then the costs associated there. So you can do your comparison on those estimated monthly costs. And then you can also take a look at the source utilization and capacity metrics. So you can see actual utilization that was gathered, and then you can see what the recommendation is based on. And this is a good kind of sanity check to make sure these metrics are as you expect them to be. So that concludes the demo. So we have a few getting started resources for you. You can visit our website. We also have that video demo available on YouTube that you just saw. Please also fill out the survey at the end of this presentation so that we can help improve our content moving forward. Thanks for attending. Have a great day.